science fans, this is Rachel Kosha, and you're watching Science and the Environment on the Rafi Report. I'm sure all of you have heard about the devastating earthquake and tsunami that struck Japan on Friday, March 11th. But do you know the whole story behind the earthquake and the tsunami's threat on the nuclear power plant? The Japanese have actually been preparing for a large-scale earthquake for about 30 years now. This is because the northern part of Japan sits on the intersection of four moving pieces of the Earth's crust. Even a minor shift in one plate could cause a disruption above. However, they were expecting a 7.5 at worst and were instead hit with a 9.0, the fourth largest earthquake recorded since 1990. Based on research conducted at Harvard, three of the plates all shifted at the same time. This means major disaster for anything and anyone resting on those plates. The surprise attack in Japan has left the U.S. wondering what fault lines they may be underestimating. Soon after the quake came the waves. The disruption along the crust spread to the sea floor, causing large waves to form. As the waves moved across the ocean, open ocean at 500 miles per hour, they gained in strength and number. There was no time to move to safety and very little warning. Once a tsunami hit Japan's coast, nothing was going to stand in its way, including a nuclear power plant. This disruption knocked out the plant's ability to pump fresh water into either the reactors or the spent fuel pools. This caused the fuel rods to overheat and begin to release highly radioactive material. Scientists worked quickly to bring electricity back to the reactor and start the pump to cool the rods. The situation is currently being controlled and radiation levels are being monitored. The most dangerous part of this nuclear disaster at this point in time seems to be fear. Citizens and foreigners alike have fled Tokyo due to the fear of radiation. Many have also requested potassium iodine pills, which, unless in direct threat of high levels of radiation, can have dangerous side effects. Even citizens in the U.S. are concerned that radiation could reach our air. However, there is no need to panic. If any radiation did reach the U.S., it would be in levels far too small to have any negative effect. Still, the situation in Japan is one news story that you should definitely stay updated with. Now it's time for the unique species of the week. This week, I'd like to introduce one of my personal favorites, the sea dragon. Yes, they do exist, but they aren't as terrifying as they sound. In fact, they are really very harmless. They also don't look very threatening and are often confused with seahorses. Though from the same family, sea dragons are actually very different. Most commonly found in Australia's coastline, sea dragons have appendages that sprout from their bodies. I'd have to say their most interesting characteristics include the fact that their eyes move independently from each other, they have no teeth, and they have no stomach. That concludes this week's episode of Science and the Environment on the Rafi Report. I'm Rachel Kosha, and I will see you all next week.